Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings.
Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
Oh shit, we crazy.
What the fuck? I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
This is our last, by the way.
Thrown down a... What?
Anybody want to read that? I'll let it sit there for a minute. I would, but, no.
Twelve years ago, I made a mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo.
Everything that has happened. I just want what's best for you.
Everybody's in on it.
These don't belong to Dr. Lin. Tuning peg.
What the hell going on, bro? I thought we were shot in the face.
Is that what I look like? Really?
Yes.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
Thank you.
Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure.
I think it's going to be a case number.
I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
I'm just waiting on the shooter to drop, bro. That's it. This whole thing is bizarre to me. From there. Neither knows. I thought you shot you in the face or something. It's not. Hey, you too, Pop. Title of this episode, Alex Tupac Chain Shakur. Back up there, bro. We shot. We bleeding. I don't know what's gonna happen, bro. This can't be heaven. Heaven don't need no lights like that.
Gabe?
Maybe this is heaven.
You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave.
This must be like a heaven waiting room. You think God has a waiting room? He probably do. Millions of people want to get into heaven every day. So, I wouldn't doubt it.
Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me. It was always too hot in this room.
I'm still trying to wonder what's going on here.
How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating with Ben. There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry.
This hospital don't care, man. Like, this ain't how you, like, hook somebody up. It's a little bit of the ass room. Oh, come on, bro.
Hi, Mom.
Don't turn your head like that. Like a zombie.
Mom. Mom.
She got COVID.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. Wait. Did I miss something?
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom, are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while, but I am going to be okay.
Let me check the
no
water.
Matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry. She knew. Even then, she knew.
Trying to see what I missed. Evidently, I missed something. So, what is it?
We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was
trying to see what we missed.
Scary.
scared me to death. There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess.
What did we miss here, man? Please say we missed something. I don't see anything that we missed. So I'm gonna talk to her again. And see if I, hold on, let me check the room. Much to look at, so I know I didn't miss anything else.
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Hey, I know what it is because I was messing with it earlier. I feel proud of myself. There goes some water. It's tough watching somebody, like, I'm assuming she got cancer. It's tough watching somebody go through that. It really is, because there's nothing you can do.
You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? Your brother, your father, they are going to need you. You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex?
I was waiting on them to say something, because I didn't want to over-talk nobody, but she just stared at the TV. I still want to know what happened, because I got shot in the face, or the head, and I'm in the well, so how the hell am I over here? I'm all types of confused. But I am proud of myself, cause I told y'all. I watch a lot of shows, and I know it's usually the person you never expect. So I knew it was him.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
I think so.
Hey.
Do you miss her?
What question is that? Of course.
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both. This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
I think he's trying to, like, unlock some trauma. Well, her brain is unlocking some trauma that she may have suppressed. I ain't gonna lie, this kind of sound like a song that Eminem will rap on right before he tell you that he don't like his fucking stepdad. My stepdad. Okay, it's not that song, but it still sounds like something that he would rap about when he was in Trailer Park. Oh my god. Bro. I swear to y'all, I haven't played this. That just blew my freaking mind. Like, I know they're not about to play Eminem's version, but just the fact that I brought that up and they playing that. Oh my god, I'm a genius. I feel like one anyway.
It's okay, it's just me.
Oh my god.
But you know that's not how it went down, right?
How it go down?
Thank you.
I was thinking you telling me.
It was my job.
Stuff didn't go down the way I meant it.
But no matter
what. Alright, if it went down that way, if it didn't go down that way, let me believe it, okay? Let me deal with the trauma my way.
The killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right.
He's like, hey, Alex, you know it didn't go down that way. No, I didn't know it didn't go down that way, Gabe.
Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me.
I'm trying to make sure I ain't got anything right here I can analyze. You know what I'm saying? Trying to get them collectibles.
Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world. This was probably the most expensive thing we owned. It kind of kept me sane.
You understand how it went down there, right?
I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume.
We don't have to go upstairs, do we?
I can't believe they were ever this happy.
That's how it be sometimes, man. Your parents start off great, and then they end up hating each other. That ain't what happened with my parents. I think they just hated each other from the get-go. But
hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... Yeah, that was like rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there. Okay?
Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about.
So you came from a pretty broken family.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke. Again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We could sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't want to hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad.
Damn it. Alex.
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad. Dad, it's okay. Really. I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Dad?
Someone will come. That woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad.
I'm sorry.
No. No. Dad!
You better not walk at that fucking door. You just walk out there like that? I ain't never seen nothing like that before. Like, my dad wasn't there, but he didn't walk out there like that. Mr. Chen is a fucking savage dickhead. I couldn't even lie and say he was going to get the milk.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You were 12, I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Play my
part. Say that one more time. I'm gonna fuck you up.
I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit. I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
I'll make sure I look at everything I can.
God, they put me on so many meds.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped, a little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense,
no, medicine,
mutant empathy
no pill
exactly
can fix anybody, bro. Medication doesn't fix people. It may help a little bit, but it doesn't fix people. At least I don't think so. Dramatic music going. Something about to happen. That's what I thought.
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What is that?
Well, yes, ma'am. Me too.
why she's never found a home before. She's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something broken. Wrong.
With her.
She's held in so many emotions. That must be tough, man. To go to the foster system and have these parents judge you and say all these things about you. Well, they may not say it to the kid directly, but the kid hears it, man. That's rough.
I'm sorry.
Why?
Need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us.
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
Okay. I guess. She gotta be the luckiest girl in the world. Cause she should be dead. How are you moving like this? I know this is a game, but damn. You are strong.
got to find a way out of here.
Hopefully we do. I'm just looking around and seeing if it ain't nothing I can, I thought I got collectible or something.
I'm gonna choose not to read anything into this.
Right.
I could almost laugh.
Big ass vampire pop out of these motherfuckers.
So much.
Like, I know it ain't a horror game, but she do got magical power, so anything can happen. We may need to pick this up.
How long has this stuff been down here?
I looked away for 5 seconds. I didn't see what happened.
I can do this. I can do this.
What happened?
Okay. That's something.
I gotta put my phone. I'm gonna do my fear real quick.
That aura is the only lead I've got.
This is getting real creepy. I ain't gonna say I'm scared, but I ain't gonna say I'm not scared. You hear me? There's a lot of things going on right now.
All right, boys, getting close.
Helldivers for life, huh, Jed? Dig so deep, we see where the devil sleeps.
Goddamn right.
This is it. This is what Typhon tried to bury.
A lot of runoff moisture in this soil. Jed, we gotta call it. This dig is fucked.
Nothing's fucked.
Jed, we got no pumps running. No.
My teams have never quit a dig this deep before. We finish the job.
I knew he was
steady
the devil.
Goes. Steady.
Fuck was...
Move! Come on! Clear the tunnel! Who's on radio?
Jed!
Fuck!
Jed! Jed!
Oh my god.
We gotta move! Now! There's still men back there! They'll drown!
Yeah, and so will we if we don't get the fuck out! Make the call, Jed!
God damn it! God damn it! Everyone, let's go! Now!
Smells like fireworks. Must be where Typhon blew the charges.
This.
Chen, you gotta stop, man.
Chen! Fuck you, Chen! Come back!
It's over, Chen. He's not coming back.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's crazy. He left the girl's father. He killed the girl's brother. Like, this dude is the devil. Shouldn't we be like getting to a hospital? I ain't no doctor, but yeah. I can't wait to see the look on his face. We woke up in that bitch like Makaveli.
And during my time here,
you alive?
I've come to realize what makes Haven so special. It's a flower shop. Run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer by name. It's a spring festival tradition going back 100 years. History, loyalty, pride. These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful. It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven. We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Thank you, Diane. I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks. And then lunch.
Yeah, you motherfucker, stop. What's that, huh? Yeah, you thought I was dead, didn't you, Jed? I see the fear in your eyes.
Alex, oh my God.
I'm fine.
You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
I found out something you need to hear. I'm sorry.
What?
Alex, you're hurt.
I gotta tell my truth.
Help? We can call
which is the truth.
Haven's been lying to all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Alex. What's going on?
You know exactly what's going on. I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years. Jed Lucan isn't a hero. That whole story is a lie. Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up.
in case it jeopardized the vote. All they care about is making more money. They'll do whatever it takes to push this expansion through. So they decided to bury the evidence. And nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were four people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too. Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
Try me.
These accusations are, well, they're insane. And trying to go into the mine was obviously a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do. But we all sympathize with your situation. You've been through so much. Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss. Something to give you comfort and make your life seem less unfair.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad, do you have any idea what Alex is talking about?
No, I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died. I thought, I don't know, I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her. All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
This is an act. You're lying. Please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too. But I'm telling the truth.
I believe you. Of course I do.
I would like to speak. This young lady came to Haven as a stranger. But over the last few weeks, she's become one of us. Now, her story certainly seems unlikely, if not impossible. But she deserves at least an investigation of her claims. We ought to take her seriously.
Ducky, you're being unhelpful. Alex, sweetheart. You know our mind can play tricks on us. None of it is your fault. It's so hard to admit you need help.
But I don't.
But struggling alone. No. You shouldn't have to go through that. We're all worried about you. Let us help you.
Charlotte. No. Leave me alone. I don't want any more of this. They killed Gabe. What are you trying to do? Take down Typhon? That won't bring him back. All I know is everything falls to shit when you're involved. There's something wrong with you, Alex. And now there's something wrong with me. I can't help you. I'm sorry.
I didn't make no friends.
How about you?
I heard you out last night. You know the deal.
Please. You're a cop. You can do something.
Alex, just give it up.
You coward. You believe me, right? Ryan?
Why are you doing this? My dad is not a murderer. Were you afraid we couldn't get Typhon? Is that why you need someone else to blame? I thought we were in this together. For Gabe.
Ryan.
No. I'm not gonna let you do that to me anymore.
Ryan, what the hell? I know he's your dad, but look at her. Why would she lie about this?
It's going too far.
Alex almost died.
It's not true.
Fuck you, Ryan! After everything? Seriously, fuck you!
Stop. I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John.
He was a screw up.
He made a lot of mistakes. He wasn't a good father. I think he came here trying to be better. But you killed him. And then Gabe, my big brother. You know, when we were kids, we goofed around to escape. To pretend everything was better for a little while. When I got to Haven, The first thing we did was dance around like total dorks. And it wasn't an escape from anything. He was happy for the first time in his life. But he died. Because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive. To get through. Haven changed me. I started to think about the future. I want to help people. Because it's something I'm good at. Knowing I'm good at something feels fucking great. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth. You've forgotten it, haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero. A strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices. Decisions that could lead to people dying. Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Eleven years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And you were too selfish to say those words out loud. There was so much to lose. The love of your wife. The respect of your son. The comfort and ease you had walking around the world. All of that mattered more to you than those men's lives. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't. The truth hurts. Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. See the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows. I know who you are. I've seen the worst parts of you.
Should I forgive him? No, fuck that. We condemn it. Man, my brother, I don't care about forgiving you. I don't owe you no fucking peace.
And I condemn you.
Oh.
Okay. That was some time of events.
And the news is still coming in on the Titan mining scandal that has rocked the western slope town of Haven Springs, where a council meeting was the scene for shocking revelations. Local bar owner and council president Jed Lucan admitted in a tearful confession to covering up the deaths of 7 Typhon employees as their manager 12 years ago. A recent cover-up, which involved a clandestine and unpermitted explosion to thwart inspections, caused the death of Haven local Gabe Chen last month. Mr. Lucan is currently in police custody awaiting arraignment. We will have plenty more about this developing story, including the resignation of Typhon CEO, the market impact, and what it all means for your drive time commute coming right.
Yeah, the silence is worse. I need to get some air.
Indeed.
After summoning all my strength and willpower, I'm now ready to move from the bed to the rooftop.
I see something over here. I don't know.
You ever swing a pick before, Mr.
Chen? John. And no. But I'm a hard worker, and I learn fast, and I don't mind long hours.
You don't have somebody waiting on you at home?
No, sir.
Well, John, guess you're a hell diver now.
All right.
I'll never understand exactly what happened to me down there, but I'll always be grateful.
I don't know what happened to you down there either.
You left it on the landing outside. He still can't even look at me. Chad must have thought he was seeing a ghost the first time Gabe walked in.
I bet he did.
Maybe Dad deserved everything he got, but I'm still glad we were there with him in his last moments. I love this guitar, but if it starts asking me riddles again, I'm throwing it out the window.
All right, let's go.
Hey, Steph.
Alex, wait. Before you say anything, I have to get this out.
Okay.
What you did at the council meeting, it was the bravest thing I've ever seen. And it made me want to be brave, too. So, here it goes. I want to be with you. I don't give a shit about playing music or seeing the world. I mean, I do, but only if it's with you. And if you'd rather stay here instead, then... fuck it. I want to stay here, too.
You ripped your bus ticket.
I can get another one. Or not. It doesn't matter. Point is, I'm in. For whatever you want.
You've given me a lot to think about.
Well, good. That was the idea. You know where to find me. Good luck, Chen.
Thanks, Steph.
I say we go. I mean, what else is here? Unless you got a couple kids I don't know about. You might as well go. Nothing else is here.
All right. Just tell me.
What?
My future. What to do? The night of the Spring Fest, Steph made a strong push for leaving with her. Playing on the road, the excitement of the unknown. Of course, that was before all the shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
You really think so?
Of course. You finally have a home, a job, and despite what happened at the vote, people that actually care about you. Why would you give that up?
That's true.
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off. Stop it, Gabe. I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
But here's something. It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. And neither is Steph. Life goes on. You get a job working with Steph at the record store. All those years of being a music snob finally pay off. And little by little, time does its thing. The apartment starts to feel less like a museum and more like a home. Thoughts of Jed, of Typhon, even of me, begin to fade into the background. Your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans. Maybe while you play, you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all. You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you. And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it, you don't doubt it, or wonder what might have been. It's your life, the life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You really think I'll transform Haven?
Of course. You already have. With your gift, your music, just by being you. But Alex, that doesn't mean you have to stay. You have the potential to do that anywhere you go.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't have any other home.
That is true, but you didn't have any home before coming here. And look what happened. The truth is, there's no telling what that version of your future might be. The only promise is the adventure. So, what do you think?
I think we should go. I want to seek adventure. And then if I want to come back, she can always come back. But she got to go find herself. So I see adventure.
I know what I want.
That life he showed sounds great, but I feel like she needed a whole new chapter, man. I just do. Yo, I don't hear nothing. I hope I picked the right future for her. I hope she becomes like a star and they enjoy their life together.
Hello, everyone. I'm Alex Chen.
Okay, that's one more series down. I think the people who all view this, you know, whether it be 2 people, 4 people, 10 people, it don't matter. I appreciate it. Yeah. Now we can focus on Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy. And then we can play Ghost of Ashes, I think that's what it's called. We can play that right after I send this back to Gamefly. You know? But yeah, I'm out.